Hello, teacher. Good morning. How are you?
Good morning, guys. Very good. And you, Mr. Diego? How are you, Mr.?
Good, teacher. Thanks.
Excellent.
Hi, teacher. Good morning.
Good morning. Nice to hear you. Also to see you. Hey, what?
No, profe, es que es la tele de mi hermano que está viendo lo de Aprende en Casa.
Ah, okay. That's okay, that's okay.
Good morning, teacher.
Good morning, Kevin. Nice to hear you.
Hola, profe.
Good morning, Robert. How are you, mister?
I don't sleep and I don't eat, so.
Why not? What happened?
I don't eat because I sleep a lot, but yesterday I go to the bed last that two in the night so late, so.
Ah, okay. But you are okay. Yeah. That is the most important.
Hello. La una de la mañana.
Ah, okay.
I am not in coma.
Ah, okay. Okay.
Profe,
dígame.
Me sacó algo.
What? Tell me what. Ah, okay. Thank you, José Roberto. Excellent. Nice. It looks like a church, but it's not a church. Okay.
Because está muy grueso.
Ajá. Okay, Vale Rojas. Thanks for telling me. It was your cat, Annie. Yes. Yes, sometimes cats give us like a heart attack. Thank you, Robert. You are detailing my house. Okay, so I am going to call the list, okay, guys? Okay, give me a moment. Okay, I am going to call the list. Diego Bañuelos is here.
Present.
Yes.
Present.
Yes, yes, thank you. Kevin is here. Reina, okay, wait, wait, wait for me, Reina. Okay, Barbara.
Present.
Is here. José Roberto is here. Jimena Espinosa.
Here.
Is here. Tamara Renata. Is not here. Dennis. Not here, Dennis. Really? That's strange. Brittany. No, Brittany here. That is also strange. Peter. Dime.
Profe, sí está.
Yes.
Es que se trabó.
Ah, okay. So Brittany is here. Let me check.
Present teacher.
Ah, yes, he's here. I see.
Sí, estaba.
It was strange for me not to see Brittany. Peter, not here. Dani Valenzuela.
Present.
Okay. Leti Amejali.
Present.
Thank you. Fernando Chavero.
Present.
Thank you. Rodrigo García. No. Maximiliano Hurtado. No. Vale Rojas. Is here. Yes.
Present teacher.
Reina. Reina is not here. What happened to Reina?
Profe, ¿cómo se ríe?
¿Me?
Yes, no. Teacher.
No, me. No, really.
Yes, teacher.
It wasn't me.
Sí, le voy luego, luego la cara.
Peter, ay, Peter, tell me present, mister. Okay, Peter, Peter, he's here. Okay. So I am with Reina. Eder.
Present teacher.
Okay, Abascal.
Present.
Luis Fabián. No, Luisito.
No, ya, yeah, 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 present.
Okay. Yes, Reina, I know your internet. Okay. Sebastián Víctor.
Present.
Christopher Abraham.
Present teacher.
Thank you, Christo. Ingrid Arlette.
Present.
Thank you. Carolina. Carito.
Present.
Thank you.
Present.
Ángel Venegas.
Here.
Thank you. Ángel Díaz. Ángel. Adriana Camila.
Present.
Thank you. En Santiago Salachaga. Santiago.
Mande.
Say present, mister.
Present.
Santiago.
¿Dónde?
I need your... ¿Sí? Necesito el teléfono de tu papá y tu mamá para meterlo al grupo. Ahí está tu papá o tu mamá, o más bien tu papá, porque es el que más había visto. ¿O te sabes el número de tu papá?
Si quiere, lo llamo.
Órale, porfas. Ok, chicos, mientras en lo que llega el papá de Santi. ¿Ya?
¿Prof?
Dígame.
Mi papá no puede venir porque está en una videoconferencia, pero me dio su número.
A ver, pásamelo, por favor.
Es 7:33.
Ajá.
101.
Uh-huh. 23. Sí. 44. Ok, sí, más tardecito cuando estés con él, nada más avísale que lo voy a meter al grupo para que le lleguen los avisos. ¿Sale?
Sí, yo le avisé.
Ok. Chicos, rapidísimo, lo que les tengo que decir es, en la plataforma todos, bueno, casi la gran mayoría, yo sé que han entrado, los que no, pues empiecen a entrar, ¿sí? ¿Qué es lo que vamos, profe? No escucho, pero presente, sí, Reina, ya estás. Entonces, lo que estábamos haciendo era subir los archivos y ustedes ya iban subiendo por día, ¿verdad? Ahora lo que voy a hacer, voy a cambiar esta forma para que sea algo más simple y más práctico para ti. ¿Cómo le vas a hacer? Bueno, la actividad del día de hoy, ¿sí? Le vamos a poner fecha, obviamente, también vamos a poner fecha en libros, ¿sí? Y entonces, lo de hoy, lo de mañana, miércoles y jueves, lo vas a poner en un solo archivo, ¿sale? Ese archivo va a estar en plataforma y solamente va a decir Evidence of Work. Si ustedes se han dado cuenta, en su plataforma hay un archivo que así lo subo. Se llama Evidence of Work y tiene una fecha. Por ejemplo, tiene la fecha de hace 8 días, del 5 al 9 de octubre. Tienen el anterior también. Entonces, en esas Evidence of Work, para que ya no estén subiendo por día, que a veces es complicado por los tiempos, tus clases, etcétera, ¿verdad? Todas tus actividades. Lo que vas a hacer ahora es todas las de la semana las vas a subir en un solo archivo. Y eso, bueno, pues es, reduce el tiempo porque ya no estás, ay, hoy tengo que subir, obviamente los que son cumplidos y cumplidas, hoy tengo que subir lo de hoy en inglés, y también tengo que subir lo de matemáticas, y también tengo que subir lo de español, etcétera. ¿Sale? Entonces, vas a subir todo lo de la semana, y yo te voy a dar hasta el sábado, si no lo haces el viernes, pues el sábado, ¿verdad? Te digo el viernes porque no tenemos clase, ¿verdad? Pero si tienes tus otras clases. Pues sábado, pues aunque es tu día de descanso, ¿sí? Si ya tienes todo guardado en el archivo, pues ya solamente lo subes, ¿sí? O el mismo jueves en la noche, no sé, ahí ya es organización personal. Subes todo en ese archivo y ya no estás subiendo por día, sino ya todo. Lo único que sí te pido que tengas organizado es la fecha, ¿sí? Lo de hoy, pues hasta yo también voy a poner fecha ahí en el libro para que tanto tú como yo tengamos ese orden y esa organización y lo hagamos pues, de una forma más práctica, ¿sí? No por día. Aparte de que pues, sí me facilitas un poquito a mí esa tarea, porque como ya todo va a estar subido en una sola carpeta, no tengo que estar abriendo y cerrando a cada rato y estar checando a uno por uno. ¿Sí? Entonces, igual lo voy a checar uno por uno, pero pues ya ahí, por ejemplo, voy a abrir la de Bárbara, ¿sí? Y ya va a estar ahí todo lo de Bárbara, todo lo de esta semana, del 12 al 15, ¿sale? Ya chequé todo lo de Bárbara del 12 al 15, sale, me voy con otro alumno, Valeria. Y así de manera sucesiva. ¿Sale? ¿Tienen alguna pregunta, chicos, de esto?
No, maestro.
No, seguro. No, seguro, ¿seguras? Entonces voy a estar diciéndoles a diario, ¿saben qué? Esto, para que también recuerden ustedes qué es lo que tienes que hacer y ya no estés subiendo del día por día, sino todo en uno solo, ¿sí? Más rápido, más práctico y pues nos quita menos tiempo a que esté subiendo del diario, sino cada jueves, ¿sí? Al final de la clase, después en la tarde-noche, ¿sí? O el día viernes, o el día sábado, o el día domingo, ¿sale? Ya va a estar subida esa carpeta, ¿sale? Vamos a iniciar entonces. We are going to begin with a new unit, ¿yes? In this unit, it is called... Places at home. Yes, places at home. All right. What are the places in your house? What are the places in your house? Tell me one place in your house.
The bedroom.
Bedroom, okay. I am going to write here. Bedroom. Uh-huh. Another one.
Restroom. In the garage. Kitchen.
Kitchen. Uh-huh. Bathroom. Bathroom.
Living room.
Living room, somebody says. Uh-huh. What else?
Sir, how do you say sala de estar?
Sala, living room. Okay, another one. Comedor, how do you say comedor? No, no idea.
Studio.
Dining, also we have the studio. The garden, exactly. Yes, number six, we have garden. That is not actually a garden, students. Garden, we consider this place that is in the Zócalo of every town. So in your house, we have basically two parts. Front yard and back yard. Yes, so change a little bit your vocabulary. It's okay, I'm not saying that it's not. It's okay to mention garden because yes, automatically you have in your, you have the picture in your mind of green areas, trees, chairs, etc. Okay, but basically only no yet the page, Mr. Diego. First, let me check all the vocabulary and everything we are seeing in this unit. So coming back, it's okay to say garden, but it's preferable and it's more correct to say front yard and backyard. All right. So we don't have more parts in the house. What about the garage for cars?
The door.
Door? Yes. No, what about where your mom washes your clothes? What is the name? No idea? Laundry room. No? Where is Hoover? Well, sometimes right there is, it is also the what is the name of this? The, well, it's because it only exists in Mexico, the lavadero. Okay, so that object, yes, where your mommy or sometimes you or your dad, why not, washes different clothes. Yes, all right, no more parts in your house? In some house also we have studio. Sometimes they also have the TV room. Yes, etc. Well, houses like with bigger space, right? That's the reason this house in today's class, all right? Because we are going to be talking about different places in your house. Also different. Pay attention to this word. Furniture at home. Furniture at home. Do you know what are the furnitures at your house? Yes or no? Students, can you tell me some furniture at home?
¿Cómo se decía? ¿Dónde están los peces?
Ah, that is the water pond. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
But furniture, ¿sí saben qué es furniture or not? Exactly.
Por favor.
So, can you tell me what are some furnitures at home?
This?
No? For example, we have chair, table, stop. What else?
Desk.
Uh-huh. What else? Armchair. Sofa, bed, lamp, more furniture in your house? No? Lop seat, plant, that is not a furniture, but it's part of the furniture. Yes. Coffee table.
TV stand.
TV stand. Uh-huh. Your bookshelf. Yes, your keyboard. Yes, all of this, okay? So all of this we are going to check today. Places at home, furniture at home. Okay, no problema?
No.
No, students? Okay, so now let's go directly to here. Here we have my place.
¿Debemos de copiar eso?
My home. No. No, in a moment. No. Okay, here you have. Watch the video and discuss the questions. Okay, so we're going to watch a video. Where do you live? Who do you live with? How many bedrooms are there in your home? Do you share your bedroom? What is the most interesting thing about your room? Would you like to live in an unusual house? Okay, so let's watch this video. Wait. Okay, ready for this video? One.
Yes.
Two. Three.
This film looks at homes. I live in a house in the south of England. In my house, there are seven rooms, a kitchen, a living room, two bathrooms, and three bedrooms. I share a bedroom with my brother. Where do you live?
In Cardiff, by the sea. I live in the north of Cardiff. Never mind. I live in Cardiff, by the bay. I live in the centre of Cardiff, near shops and schools.
And who do you live with?
I live with my mum, dad and sisters and brothers.
I live with my mum, my stepdad and my two sisters.
I live with my mum, my brother and my sister.
I live with my dad and my brother.
And how many bedrooms does your house have?
Four. I have three bedrooms. My house has four bedrooms. There are three bedrooms in my house.
And do you share a bedroom?
No, I don't, but my sisters do.
I share with my younger sister.
I do not share a bedroom.
Tell me something interesting about your bedroom.
My bedroom is big, and I have a bed, and a TV, and a wardrobe. And I also have One Direction posters. I've got a bed with a desk underneath.
My room's big. I have a wardrobe, a telly, and a bed. My room's pink and white. It's black, red, and white.
Would you like to live in an unusual house, like a boat?
I would like to live in a boat because then I can travel around the world. I'd love to live in a tree house. I'd like to live in a house though. I'd like to live in a camper van.
Okay, guys, we're going to watch it again. Just wait. Yes, and maybe somebody wants to watch it again. Okay, so here is it. Number one, listen how students answer questions. Yes. Where do you live? I live in a small house. Okay, complete answer. All right. And these students are maybe your age, similar to you. Okay. So the answers they are giving are complete. Not only where do you live? House. Who do you live with? My mom. So no, they answer, they respond, yes, in a complete form, number one, yes. And number two, yes, check how they are analyzing, they are creating information because they ask where would you like to live, all right? Well, in fact, the question is, would you like to live in an unusual house? And all of them, imagine, I would like to live in a tree house. I would like to live in a camp or in a van, all right? So this is what you need to do. So I'm going to watch it one more time. Let me ask you, is the sound okay? Or do you prefer more sound? Students, ¿está bien el sonido o más sonido? What is it, Vale? Dani, sorry.
No,
No, no, la levanté sin querer.
Okay. So it's okay the sound, or do you want more sound?
It's okay.
It's okay. So one more time. One, two, three.
This film looks at homes. I live in a house in the south of England. In my house, there are seven rooms, a kitchen, a living room, two bathrooms, and three bedrooms. I share a bedroom with my brother. Where do you live?
In Cardiff by the sea.
I live in the north of Cardiff, near a mountain.
I live in Cardiff by the bay.
I live in the centre of Cardiff, near shops and schools.
And who do you live with?
I live with my mum, dad, and sisters and brothers.
I live with my mum, my stepdad, and my two sisters.
I live with my mum, my brother, and my sister.
I live with my dad and my brother.
And how many bedrooms does your house have?
Four. I have three bedrooms.
My house has four bedrooms.
There are three bedrooms.
Do you share a bedroom?
No, I don't, but my sisters do.
I share with my younger sister.
I do not share a bedroom.
Tell me something interesting about your bedroom.
My bedroom is big, and I have a bed, a TV, and a wardrobe. And I also have one electric upstairs. I've got a bed and a desk in the room.
My room's big. I have a wardrobe, a telly, and a bed. My room's pink and white. It's black, red, and white.
Would you like to live in an unusual house, like a boat?
I would like to live in a boat because then I can travel around the world. I'd love to live in a tree house. I'd like to live in a house, though. I'd like to live in a camper van.
Okay, guys. So I am going to be asking the same questions about this video, right? The same questions. So please try to answer like more or less like these students. For example, Brittany. No, wait. Sorry. For Barbara.
Yeah.
Where do you live, Barbara? Yes, Barbara. Ah, okay. Well, let me pass to another student, Barbara. Thank you. Luis Fabian. Yeah, don't worry, Barbara. Don't worry. Later. Okay. Luis Fabian, please open up your microphone.
Ya no me dejas prender el micrófono esto.
Ok, ya estás aquí. Luis Fabián, where do you live?
Se trabó, es que está mal esto. Me está trabando cada rato.
Ok, bueno, pero tienes que participar en las siguientes veces, ¿ok? Carolina Ramírez. Ok, Caro, where do you live?
I live in Nevado, Toluca.
Okay. Who do you live with?
Sure.
Yes. Who?
I live with my mom, my grandma, grandmother, and my sister.
Okay. And finally, how many bedrooms are there in your house?
There are a place.
Okay, great. That
six bedrooms.
And
yes.
Yes,
six
great
bedrooms and one living room, a kitchen, and ¿cómo se decía? Backyard. Patio trasero.
Yes,
patio delantero.
Backyard. Excellent. That is the correct form, right? That is the correct form of, yes.
Teacher, can I say something?
Yes.
I put a lot of attention of the video, and I see that they have a lot of culture because I see a book of Harry Potter teacher.
Yes, exactly. Well, actually, they are students from Europe. Well, the United Kingdom, you know, is where basically Harry Potter produce the production of these movies. So, yeah. Okay. Another student, Letia Mejali.
Yes, bro.
Okay, Letia Mejali, do you share your bedroom?
What is
share? Good question. Compartir. Do you share your bedroom?
No.
No, I don't. What is something interesting about your bedroom?
That I don't have TV.
Excellent. All right. Excellent. All right. So, vámonos rapidísimo porque me quedan 3 minutos. All right. Al rato sigo preguntando. Ok. Vocabulary and reading. Ejercicio número 1. Match the words to the box A to K in the pictures. All right. So, ahí encima de su libro, póngale. What is the letter A? What's the letter A in your house? That one that is in the book. What is it again? What is the letter A?
Profe, que la letra que está señalando.
Okay, the letter A. Ahí está, ceiling. What is the ceiling? El techo. Ok, ceiling. Escríbanle ahí, letter A. Letter B.
Balcony.
Balcony, perfect. Right, right there, balcony. Letter C. No? First floor. Primer piso. First floor. Letter D.
Garage.
Garage. Excellent. E. Sink. Sink. Where your mommy washes dishes, plates, glasses, etc. F. That is the cooker. Cooker, the place where your mommy cooks cakes. G.
No.
Cupboard. Where your mommy keeps, yes, all the cups, all the glasses. All right. And one more. H. What is the letter H?
Sofa.
Sofa. Sale, chicos. Los veo de regreso a las 10 de la mañana para completar ese ejercicio. All right.
Okay.